Hello everyone! Today I'm gonna make a different kind of video. Today I'm gonna talk about my experience, the pros and cons of working from home. Because it's been a little more than a year now that I've been working from home full time. So I work my 40 hours a week. What do? I'm an online teacher. I teach English and I teach Italian. And I do other things too, but the main job is this, online teaching. I don't work for a company, so it means that I have full control of all my decisions, which could be good and bad, but this is a different topic. Today, I mainly want to talk about pros and cons of working from home. And also my husband, Brian, he is a YouTuber slash does many, many things, but he works from home too. Let's get to it. I apologize for the messy look, but I was just teaching and now I have a break and I thought I really wanted to make this video. So here I am. Let's start with the pros, you know, let's start with the positive sides of working from home. So the first thing you're probably thinking, and you're right, is the commute time is no commute. Yes. I wake up upstairs and I work downstairs. Woo-hoo. This is nice. I do appreciate it a lot because I don't like to drive. It's true. I usually just wake up 90 minutes before I start teaching so that I can get ready, have breakfast, prepare my day a little bit and start teaching. So nice, because I don't like to wake up early. I know you're probably like jealous a little bit right now, but there are cons too, so just wait a bit. So the second positive side is financial. I mean, it's kind of like related to the commute. I don't have to pay for an office. I don't have to spend a lot of money on gas or parking, train tickets, because I have no commute. Of course, I have to pay for good Wi-Fi and other things, but I mean, it's cheaper than working somewhere else, unless they pay for all your expenses. The third pro, and this is like really important to me, I'm a little anxious. I'm a little bit anxious. Working from home means that I don't really spend a lot of time with other people except for my students, but I don't have my manager right next to me. I don't have a boss looking at me. Pros and cons, guys. This is not always a good thing, but for me, since I'm a little bit anxious and I'm a perfectionist, I always need to be perfect and the best and prepared and everything. If I have a manager, if I have a boss looking at me, I feel the pressure a lot, maybe because I'm a perfectionist. And I always want to give 100%, but it's realistically not doable to do it all the time. And it used to give me a lot of stress. There are some positive sides of having a manager right there or a boss right there, it's true. But I have to admit, lower stress levels overall, just because I am my supervisor and I'm a very strict supervisor. Guys, trust me, like I'm probably the worst boss because I want a lot and I push myself a lot, but overall I feel less stressed. The fourth pro is probably having a more flexible schedule. Of course, since I'm a teacher, it's not like I work on a website. I still have to follow a certain schedule. Like if I have lessons from 10 to 1, from 10 to 1, I cannot do anything else. But I am able to optimize the time before and after I work. If I need to go to the grocery store, if I need to be here because Amazon's coming to deliver a package, I'm here. It's convenient. It is. Plus, since I also work for myself, I'm also able to adjust my schedule a little bit. Of course, I have to consider my students' needs, but that's a little different because working from home doesn't necessarily mean working independently. But in general, I think you are able to optimize your time a little bit more. But these are the pros that I can think of right now. I mean, I have to admit that last winter, I wasn't feeling so good for like a week or so. I was feeling a little bit under the weather. And since I was teaching online, I just wore my pajamas pants. Couldn't have done it at an office. But now let's talk about the cons. Yes, there are some cons. And I've seen it mainly with Brian because I like working from home maybe more than Brian does, my husband. The first con is not having co-workers. You can imagine why, because maybe you feel lonely, maybe you want to talk a little bit with someone else, maybe you want to talk to someone who is in your same position, or even because it's easier to learn because they're all in the same field and you see and you learn. But with my job, when I want some training, I need to go and find online courses, online training. So it's a little bit more complicated. In an office, you feel like you're a part of a group, but here it's just you. It gets lonely sometimes. Con number two, this is not mine because I have a gift. I can focus. For real, I can focus for hours. If I'm doing something, I just start working and I don't even hear you if you call me. That's crazy, but I like it. Brian doesn't, because when I'm focused, I'm like, later, and I just keep working. But overall, I'd say that it is harder to focus if you're at home because you have so many distractions and you have your TV and you have your dog. My dog's right there. People calling. I mean, you might argue that it's the same at an office. It is, maybe, but you also have the motivation of I need to focus, everybody's here, everybody's watching me, I must work. Here, when I teach, I have to teach. It's not like I can just go and watch TV, of course, but if you had a different job, like Brian's job, maybe you have to make a YouTube video. It's easy to get distracted, especially because there's no one there looking at you, so 5 more minutes, 10 more minutes. Then, this is especially true for me and a bit less for Brian. It's hard to stop working because when you work in the same place you live, even though you're working days over, you know, your computer's still there, your agenda's still there, you know, you have to make a lesson plan, you know, you have to get back to that student, make that exercise, correct that voice message. It's hard to say like, oh, okay, today I taught for 7-8 hours, I'm done. You still want to work, at least I do, and it's really hard for me to say, this is my weekend, I shouldn't do anything. Brian is a little bit better at this. Overall, I'd say that working from home is good for me because of this big, big, big pro. I can travel. My husband's American, I'm Italian, we love Japan. Working from home allows us to travel, to go to America for 3 months, go to Japan for 3 months, stay in Italy when we need to stay in Italy, and we can keep working. So it's not like, oh, let's go on holiday. No, we keep working, but we live somewhere else. So this is the main reason why I love working from home, but I won't deny that sometimes it's a little bit hard. But I think for me, the hardest part of my job is not working from home, is the fact that I work for myself. So if you're interested in this, I can make another video about working independently, working for yourself, and what it's like for me. But besides that, working from home, I don't mind it. I'm not antisocial, I'm really social, and I used to like working in my office when I was in Japan, but working from home is not a problem either. I just wanted to share my experience, and I can't wait for you guys to leave a comment below and tell me if you like these kinds of videos, if you want me to make a video about my experience as an entrepreneur. Anything. Now I should go back to work because I have a lesson soon. Thank you for watching and see you soon. Bye.